First, we are going to discuss about error in the sum of two quantities. So, sum means we have to add the two quantities. Let me discuss. Consider del A, del B are the absolute errors. That is, error in the quantity. And A, B are the two quantities. That is, A is a separate quantity and B is a separate quantity. So, we have to add the A and B. So, the measured value of A, which means the A having error in the measured value, that is represented by A equal to the measured value plus or minus error, that is del A. Likewise, the measured value of B equal to B plus or minus del B. Now, we have to sum the A and B. We get a new quantity that is called Z. Now, Z also having some error, so we have to mention the error, that is Z equal to Z plus or minus del Z. Substituting the values of A, B and Z in the equation, so we get Z plus or minus del Z equal to A plus or minus del A plus B plus or minus del B. So next step, we are going to multiply with the quantities A and B and del A and del B we have to add. So we get A plus B plus or minus del A plus del B. That means we have to add only the quantities separately and absolute errors added separately. Z plus or minus del Z. Since we know what is A plus B equal to Z. So I am changing the value here. Therefore, Z plus or minus del Z equal to Z plus or minus del A plus del B. Then cancelling both sides and we get, therefore, the error in the measured value is found, the del Z equal to del A plus del B. That means that we have to add the errors in the two quantities is equal to the sum of the new quantity error. Next, we are going to see the errors in difference of two quantities. So difference means subtract. If you are going to subtract any two values, so what is the value we found in the error? Consider del A and del B are the absolute errors and AB are the two quantities. If I measured a value of A, so the value should be A plus or minus del A. This plus or minus represents the error may increase or decrease the value. The measured value of B equal to B plus or minus del B. So we have to find the difference of the two quantities. Now I am going to subtract the value. Therefore, Z is the new quantity which we get from the difference of two quantities. Since the error will found in the Z, so we can find Z equal to Z plus or minus del Z. Now I am going to substitute the values of A, B and Z in the difference formula. So I get Z plus or minus del Z equal to A plus or minus del A, so minus B plus or minus del B. The same method, we have to subtract the difference. Okay, first we add the two quantities separately and the errors separately. So we get Z plus or minus del Z equal to A minus B plus or minus del A plus del B. Since we know A minus B is Z, so we substitute the formula. Therefore, Z plus or minus del Z equal to Z plus or minus del A plus del B. Then cancel the Z we get del z equal to del a plus del b. That means the conclusion, we have to first subtract the two quantities. If you are going to subtract the two values, we subtract the value and the error should be added. Next, we are going to see the errors in the product of two quantities. So product means we have to multiply the two values, and what about the error in the quantity we have to find. So consider del A and del B are the absolute errors and AB are the two quantities. So the measured value of A equal to A plus or minus del A. You know the value del A is the error, and measured value of B equal to B plus or minus del B. So the product of Z, the Z is a new quantity. So by the producting of A and B, we get the new quantity, that is Z equal to A dot B. Here the Z also having some error. So that is represented as Z equal to Z plus or minus del Z. Now substitute the values of Z, A and B in the product formula. We get Z plus or minus del Z equal to A plus or minus del A dot B plus or minus del B. Now listen carefully. First we have to product with A into B, then A into del B. Likewise del A into B and del A into del B. So listen, Z plus or minus del Z equal to A dot B plus or minus B A dot del B plus or minus del A dot B plus or minus del A dot del B. Now I am going to divide LHS by Z and RHS by AB. We get, so I'm going to divide, see, Z divided by Z plus or minus del Z divided by Z equal to A dot B divided by AB plus or minus A dot del B divided by AB plus or minus del A dot B divided by AB plus or minus del A dot del B divided by AB. Now we just cancel AB and AB, we getting 1, and ZZ cancel and we get 1. Since we get del Z divided by Z equal to, and also we cancel A here, B here. So we get del B divided by B plus or minus del A divided by A plus or minus del A divided by A dot del B divided by B. Since the quantity del A by A dot del B by B is very very small quantity, so I'm going to neglect from the term. We get, after neglecting, we get del Z by Z is equal to del A by A plus del B divided by B, which means the two quantities is going to add by the sum of the fractional. To discuss about error in division or quotient of two quantities, we have to divide the two quantities, and what about the error value. So consider del A and del B are the two absolute errors, A, B are the two quantities. So the measured value of A equal to A plus or minus del A, and measured value of B equal to B plus or minus del B. So we have to find the quotient. That means we have to divide the two quantities and we get a new quantity Z. Therefore, Z equal to A by B. Here, the Z also having some error, that is represented by Z equal to Z plus or minus del Z. Now, we have to substitute the values in the formula. So we get Z plus or minus del Z equal to A plus or minus del A divided by B plus or minus del B. Here I am taking A common outside in numerator, in denominator B taking common outside. I get A 1 plus or minus del A by A divided by B 1 plus or minus del B divided by B. See what I take A common from the numerator and B common take from the denominator. Then I just take the A and B as a separate. Therefore, A divided by B into 1 plus or minus del A divided by A divided by 1 plus or minus del B divided by B. Now, I am taking the denominator to the numerator and it becomes the value minus. We get A divided by B 1 plus or minus del A divided by A into 1 plus or minus del B divided by B minus, that represents the inverse of the value. So I am going to substitute the inverse inside and changing the value. Therefore, A divided by B 1 plus or minus del A divided by A into 1 minus or plus del B divided by B. See, I just substitute the minus inside and it becomes minus of plus. Next, we just multiply the value inside the quantities. We get Z plus or minus del Z equal to, since we know A by B equal to Z, so we get Z plus or minus 1 plus or minus del A by A minus of plus del B divided by B plus or minus del A divided by A dot del B divided by B. Here, del A by A dot del B by B are very small quantities. So, we are going to neglect the term and we get finally del Z by Z equal to del A by A plus del B by B. Next, we are going to see about error in the power of a quantity. So, the quantity which is in the form of power, so what about the error value? So, consider n is the power of a. The n is the power of a. We have to find the error. The new quantity Z equal to a power n. The measured value of a equal to a plus or minus del a. The error in the Z equal to Z plus or minus del Z. Now substitute the values in the formula. So we get Z plus or minus del Z equal to A plus or minus del A the whole power N. Now the N will be common to A and del A and substitute inside. We get A power N plus or minus del A power N. I am taking AN common from the value, so we get AN 1 plus or minus del A by A power N. Now I take the N in the dividing both sides, by z. So we know the value z plus or minus del z. So divided by z and z equal to, we know z 1 plus or minus del a by n, del a by a into n divided by z. Now we just cancel each other. We get 1 plus or minus del z by z equal to 1 plus or minus del a by a power n. Now again we just remove the value, we get del z by z equal to, then power move to the front, the n del a by a.